Good morning, children. Today we are going to see the science third term, our environment. Children, there are so many things around us, isn't it? Yes. A space in a person, plant, animals live is called our environment. So many things surrounding us, they are called collectively called environment. In an environment, there are so many things. They are living as well as non-living things. The living things or living organisms are called as biotic factors, and the non-living organisms are called abiotic factors. The living as well as non-living things are interact with each other. They adapt to live changes in the environment. The living organisms are plants, animals, and microorganisms and human beings. The non-living organisms are sunlight, temperature, wind, humidity, etc. Today we are going to see a community of an environment that is called ecosystem. The ecosystem is a community of living as well as non-living things. The types of ecosystem are, there are two types, natural ecosystem and artificial ecosystem. The natural ecosystem are again divided into two categories. They are terrestrial as well as aquatic ecosystem. In the terrestrial ecosystem, for example, forest, mountains, deserts. Why we are saying it's a natural ecosystem? Because they are originated by God. They are not originated by human being. There is no intervention of human beings. But natural, for example, artificial ecosystem. What is artificial ecosystem? They are created by human beings. The natural ecosystem is again divided into two, terrestrial as well as aquatic ecosystem. Terrestrial ecosystem, example, forest, mountains, desert. They are created by God. There is no intervention of human being. Artificial ecosystem is created by man. It is again divided into two categories, terrestrial ecosystem and aquatic ecosystem. Terrestrial ecosystem, which is man-made, is called, example, garden. Aquatic ecosystem, it is seen in water, example, aquarium. Now we can see the components of ecosystem. Already I told you there are two types of components, biotic as well as abiotic. The biotic are plants, animals and human beings, and abiotic are things are physical as well as edaphic. Edaphic word refers to soil. Edaphic factors are water in soil, air in soil and organic matter in soil. Again, we are going to elaborately see about the biotic components. Plants, animals and human beings and microorganisms. All these components are again divided into two, according to their feeding habit, they are divided into two categories. They are producers and consumers. Green plants, they are said to be producers. Why? Because they can prepare their own food. Green plants and other organisms, they can produce their own food by the process called photosynthesis. Why it is called photosynthesis? It's a synthesis or preparation of food in the presence of photo means light. So green plants and other organisms, they can prepare their own food, so they are called producers. They use sunlight or light energy and convert it into chemical energy. Other human beings and other animals are called consumers because they cannot prepare their own food. What is photosynthesis? Yes, photosynthesis is a conversion of light energy into chemical energy. The light energy is used to convert carbon dioxide, water and other minerals in the presence of sunlight into starch. Finally, the byproduct is called as oxygen. So during respiration, we are taking in oxygen and inhaling out or exhaling out carbon dioxide. So carbon dioxide is the byproduct of respiration, but in photosynthesis, oxygen is the byproduct which is released into the atmosphere. Next, again, consumers. What are consumers? which eat plant products as well as plants and other animals are called consumers. They are again divided into primary consumers, said to be herbivores, secondary consumers called carnivores. Herbivores, carnivores, and third category omnivores. Herbivores are animals which eat plant and plant products. Example, deer, goat, elephant, etc. Carnivores are animals which eat other animals for food. Say example, lion, tiger, etc. Omnivores eat both plant products as well as animals. For example, omnivores are human beings, owl, as well as crow. Thank you, children.